Good evening, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for inviting me to introduce this important evening as the new chairman of the Board of Directors for the Canadian Centre for Diversity. This is indeed a privilege and an honour. It is all the more meaningful to me because the mission and goals of the Intercultural Dialogue Institute align so strongly with the mission and goals of the Canadian Centre for Diversity. The presence here tonight of so many thought leaders whose influence in the world of faith, ideas, and pluralism has profoundly shaped the country and the city we all call home. It's testimony to the importance of our shared values and visions. And on a personal note, I am delighted tonight to share the podium with Philip Crawley, certainly one of our most respected thought leaders, who was the recipient of the Canadian Centre for Diversity's prestigious Human Relations Award in 2008. He also happens to be a good friend. Looking around the room, I am struck by the obvious, visible diversity we represent. But I suspect there's also a great deal of invisible diversity of ideas, ideologies, abilities, and attitudes as Canadians. And we are accustomed to seeing diversity, to hearing about it, and how welcoming we are in Canada to newcomers, how we pride ourselves on being open and accepting, and how the fabric of our society is made up of many cultures, faiths, ethnicities, traditions, and abilities, and how we are enriched through knowing and understanding the unique identities of our friends, neighbors, colleagues. The Intercultural Dialogue Institute is inspired by the teachers, and I'm going to repeat this because I didn't know that this would be shown on the video, but it's very powerful. The teachings of Fethullah Gulen, who has said, "Be so accepting that your heart becomes wide like the ocean. Become inspired with faith and love for others. Offer a hand to those in trouble. And be concerned about everyone." These are words that we would all do well to heed. And yet we know there are many in Canada today whose lived experiences demonstrate that there is still much work to be done before acceptance and respect for all is universal. Building strong communities that honor our multiculturalism, heritage, that promote universal human values, and advanced sustainable, peaceful coexistence of diverse groups within this country. It's key that such evenings as this are so vital, and it's why the Canadian Centre for Diversity is so essential. Our focus is youth. An alarming number of young people, bright, sensitive, full of promise. They feel alone, isolated, and afraid because they have been labeled different. Tonight, as Philip Crawley addresses us about the role of media in a multicultural public sphere, I reflect on the all too frequent reports in the pages of his newspaper and others across the country about the damaging effects of discrimination and bullying in our schools today. Children have access to social media and email that can make bullying more wide-ranging and dangerous than ever before, impairing the incredible progress we have made to create a society that celebrates diversity and different at the Canadian Centre for Diversity. We are addressing this pervasive threat through the Peer Leaders Network, a national youth-led initiative that engages with high school students who become diversity and inclusion leaders in their schools. It It's a year-long program that trains a core group of students in participating high schools. They collaborate on events and projects that engage and influence the whole school. Everyone gets involved. We're giving them the tools to make a difference and make change. We're turning bystanders into allies. Educators enthusiastically endorse this program because we are working with them to accomplish our goals. A safe, inclusive environment, and because it respects students by making them partners in the process, we are teaching lessons that are valuable in school and in life. We're passionate about helping to develop young citizens who will be trailblazers, leaders today and in the future. And I expect we will see many of their ranks actively involved in initiatives like this one tonight. Our challenges around diversity and inclusion are growing in ways we could not have imagined a generation ago. But we have the energy, the commitment, and the will to inspire and lead change. The kids involved in the Peer Leaders Network are extraordinary, and their experiences with this program transform them for life. As they learn to tell their stories and share their personal narratives and support others in doing the same, they understand that diversity is the collective strength that binds and unites them, enriching us as individuals and of their communities. This work is an investment, not just in the safety and human rights of our students, but in the future of our proudly diverse country. I am grateful to each and every one of you here tonight for the commitment you have shown to diversity, respect, and inclusion, and for your efforts to promote dialogue and cooperation. Together, we are making a difference. Thank you.